So today in this class, we learned about the VBA microprogramming, and this is the first class for the VBA microprogramming, right? So you start the VBA microprogramming, know the some preparation of the starting using the VBA, right, sir?
Okay.
So if you want to start the VBA microprogramming and macroprogramming also, so need some features before the starting or programming. First, need to develop a tab. By default, developer type is the hidden. But you want to use the developer. Developer type is the interact with your VBA microprogramming. You want to open the Visual Basic Editor and also the macro list. There is available. And also the command button. So developer type will be by default be disabled. So first enable the macro, enable the developer tab in the file menu bar. So go to the file menu bar, click on the option, and then customize ribbon, there is the developer tab. So click on the, it is clear? After clicking, got here, developer tab. And second thing, need to file save in the micro enable format. When you save your file type default is the Excel workbook. Excel workbook, it means .xlsx format, and this format is the micro disabled format. If you save the your coding and macros in this format, your coding and macros will be lost, will be removed, because this format not carry the micro features. So if you write the microprogramming, start the writing the microprogramming, need to save file in the micro enabled workbook. Right, and if you have a lot of work in the VBA, you do the VBA databases, create the more and more files in the VBA, and every time you need to select the micro enable workbook, sometime you miss and your code will be lost. So by default, you can set your saving format in the micro enable workbook in the file menu bar, the options. And the same, and here set your default file save as type. I have select the file Excel macro enabled workbook, and when the save our file and save as my file, by default select here macro enabled workbook. So no chance to save the Excel workbook and lose the code. It is clear?
Okay.
Second thing, your micro security, by default micro security that disable with notifications. If you disable your macros and you have write the macros, and next time open the macro file, and every time give the pop up for the enable macro, just like that. When I open the any macro file, I see the example right here. Yeah. This is the enable macro. So yeah, when they open the macro enable file, macro file in the top here, see, give the security alert for the enable macro. But this file also macro enable. So need to change here enable all macros. Enable all macros. But one question here, ki why the disable macro by default? Because macro is the important features and very useful features. So why Microsoft disable the macros, the default setting? Because if you enable the macros, you can carefully open the unknown files, unknown Excel files. Because maybe in the with Excel file get the virus. Get the VBA generated virus. So if you enable the macro, carefully open the unknown Excel file. It's clear? Okay. So three features. First need to developer tab. Second, need to your save as a micro enable workbook, and third, need to enable your micro security, right? And second thing, where is the write the code? We have write the code in the Visual Basic. Visual Basic automatically in BuildX, so no need to install extra any applications. Click on the Visual Basic and also shortcut the Alt F11 and open the VVE, Visual Basic Editor. This is the compiler for the VBA microprogramming. And when you have to open the VBA micro, open the VBA editor, two options need. First, the VBA project, and second, the properties. By default is the visual, but sometimes you are not visual these features. You can open the here. Control R, the shortcut for the Project Explorer, and second is the properties windows, right? And if you have not see here options, you can also the view options in the view menu bar, Project Explorer and properties. Then where I want to code, just see here, if we have to open the two file and see at the two file. And second thing, in the our book file, yeah, this is the book file. Book file have a 7 seed. So show here 7 seed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7 seed. And last this workbook. You can write the code anywhere. Just click here the double seed, double click on the seed one, and this is the code area. You can write here code. And also seed 2, also seed 3. But with VBA microprogramming, we have write the code in the modules. Write the code in the modules. Why? Because if you write the code in this, double click on the seed 1, and if you write any code here, this code is stored in the seed 1 properties, right? And maybe user delete your seed here. Delete your sheet here, your coding will be also lost later, right, sir? So we have to write the code in the modules, because module is the file property and is stored in the file properties. But if you write any code in the sheet and sheet 1, sheet 2, any sheet object, then code is stored in the sheet object, and then the code is when the sheet object deleted, and your code will also deleted. So will you write code? The module. Right, sir? It's clear?
Right.
Okay. So what type of the code write here? Write the event microprogram. Just like when the open the seed, run the code, when the click, double click, when the side click. This is the event microprogramming. And this programming we discuss the in the future classes. Now, understand ki I have write the code in the module. To insert, go to the insert tab, insert the module, and write your code. So how can I start the code? First is the declaration of the macro. First, declare the macro. Before the going the coding code concept, first understand the record macro. Yeah? Record macro. If you click on the record macro, your mouse and keyboard activity will be recorded. Just like click here. Type the name, click here, type the roll number. So every movement and every keyboard and mouse action will be recorded in the VBA language. And you can see the code here. In the modules, clear the module 2, write the code here. In D1, selected, active cell, the formula name, E1, selected, roll, E2, selected, right? See here, this is the VBA macro program. And you can see here, we have your record macro create the one sub, right? And in the sub, write the code. So in the VBA programming, first declare the one macros, one subject macros. This macros you can trigger from the macros list. Right, sir? So how can declare? In the insert menu bar, you can write here public sub and the name of the macro. But public is not a required. You can also write the sub. sub is the also public, right? We have write the sub and name tt and bracket open close and in the last the answer, and we have write the code between and sub and answer, right? And do you want to run this written code, go to the macros and run your macros. It's clear, sir?
Yeah.
And now discuss about the micro declaration. What name with naming method? What is naming method? If you write your code here, just like T1 is the not valid, right? You can write here just like test today. This is not valid. If you write here test dot today, also not a valid. Test comma today, also not a valid, right? If in the your macro name no have the space nor require the any special character. If you enter the any special character and any and a space in the macro's name, the name will be not accepted. And you can also insert the underscore, right? But you have not also you not write the name in the alphanumeric. Three character alphanumeric. You said T1. This is not valid. Why? When they record your macro, run your macro, select here. This is run facility is the disabled. Why? Why T1 is the range? Your range. T1 is the your range. There is. So T1 read the T1 as a range, not a your macro name. Okay, now also just like we are type your Raj1, this is the incorrect name. Why? Because also Raj1 have a also reference, cell reference. So cell reference is the three character alpha or any numeric. So avoid the enter the name 3-digit alpha numeric. So naming concept will be clear.
Yeah.
Okay. Now we discussed about the code. What code we write here? In the VBA macros, mainly four. Hello. Any doubts, sir?
Give me a minute. Huh?
Okay. So. Okay, four pillar and four main code in the VBA programming. We had a start your line of code. The mostly code we will start with this word. First is the application. Application. Second is the workbook. And third is the seeds. And fourth is the range. Just like you have write the any sentence in English language, we have start the noun and pronoun also, mostly. So in the VBA programming, write the any line of code of the with is this four object. This called the object. In the VBA micro programming, have a two part of the code. First the object, second the action and member. Also called member. Just like you want to select the A1, we are right here A1 dot select, right? A1 is the range. Range is the object. A1 is the object location, and this is the member. Select is the member, and also you can do our simple language. This is the location, and this is the action. Where what do? In the range A1, do the select. A dot is a separator between range and member. Object and member. So we have write as the create the new workbook. We have write the workbooks dot app. Now here is the object. Is the object and here is the action a member. This is the locations in the action. But here is the no have the object details, because workbook create a new workbook, new object will be created here. So object detail is not required. But you have want to the save the file. We have write here books and write the object details, that which file want to save and save as, with extension dot save as, and enter the path where do you want to save your file. Right here. So this is the workbook. Yeah. The workbook is the object. Calling for here. This is the object detail. Which object want to, and this is the action member. What do want to do, and this is the action detail. You will want to save. So this is the code concept. If we have write the first object, second the object detail, give the dot, and give the member, and give the space and member details. The space and equal. Here is the space and equal. Different member have the different rules. So here is the method. So we have right here a space the details. This is the main code. But before the starting the writing the code, we have need to understand where which object apply where. How can decide our action will be applied in the workbook, in the seed, in the range, and application. So depending on your algorithm. So first, before the starting your start the coding, need to algorithm. Because we have one step for the starting any macros. First, the analysis your problem. Second, the algo, create the algo. And third is the code. Fourth is the test and recode. And if not problem, and recode and again retest. And apply. This is the way of the write the any programming, not a VB, any program. First, then write the problem and create the shortest way. Here, if you get the problem, we have one to sending the mail. So first, analyze the your problem. I want to send the mail via Outlook, via Gmail, and we have the including the seed, everything the analyzing, and create the algorithm is the main, because algorithm depending on the code. Create the algorithm, and according to the algorithm we write the code and test your code. If you are getting any error, recode your program and retest. Recode and retest the until when your test is the completed successfully, and after then you can apply this macro in your report form. So algorithm is the main part. Just like I want to create the one format, just like here. I give the one example for the algorithm. So I want to type the name here. I type the city here and amount here, and in the here total, and apply the sum formula. And apply the all border, and apply here background color. So how can I write the algorithm for this part? So first, I'm analyze your program, and we have write the first algorithm. Start. It means declaration of the macro. Second, select. A1, enter name, select B1, enter city, select C1, enter amount, select A11, enter total, select C11, apply sum formula, select A1 to C11, apply all border. Right. This is the algorithm. So this algorithm we have entered the code. If you know you why writing the some people ask me you why writing this type of line of steps. Because if you create any macro, any automated macro programming, if you use this file and know this file and know this problem, then you can write them manually without using the algorithm. But your boss tell me to create the one macro for his problem. But problem is that with problem details and problem steps, know your boss, not know your new boss. You tell me you can create the program. That time we have the right algorithm. For if you miss any if you write the manual code and you miss any line of code, your macro will not perform properly. So first understand the problem, understand the boss problem, and write the manual step one by one, and then this step convert to code. Just like that, we have convert to code this problem. So write a code. Sub, I create the mm_1 and for this declaration, start in declaration macro, select A1. A1 is the range, right? So we have write the code here range, because A1 is belong to range. So we use the range here, just like range A1 dot select. And next code is to enter the name. So you have right here selection dot value equal to, yeah, not you can also selection also use the active cell also. Active cell dot value is equal to name. And we have copied this code and four time. Paste. This is the D1. And write the city. And this is the C1. Write here amount. Or this is the A11. Write the total. And this is the C11, write the equal sum formula. And A2 say 18. Right? Sorry. And second thing, apply the, select the A1's C11. So right here, range A1 to C11 dot borders dot line style equal to 1. Yeah, Excel continuous for the all border. And second is the range A1 to C1 dot interior for apply the color equal to maybe the blue. This is the, your code will be finished. And in the, and we have go to the any sheets and apply run this macros mm1 and we have get here. See, so algorithm what helped me? Algorithm what helped me the writing the code with step by step. Imagine you have entered the code and after the select your A1. That time, if you cursor here, enter your name and after then select the A1. This is the missing. So we have maintained the sequence. First select the A1 and then write the name. and also V1, C1. The algorithm helped me to maintain the sequence in the VBA macro program. Suppose that we have created the one macro for the applied the pivot table. In the pivot table, first required to select your data, after then apply the pivot, right? But you have not followed the algorithm and you have write the pivot code and after the selections. That time, your pivot table not work properly because your data selected after creating the pivot.
Okay.
Okay, so algorithm is the important. So, first you have the problem and try to write the step by step in the writing, because in the VBA macro programming, one line code for one word. Just like we have the write the code through select, we have the write them only for the select. So one action, one line of code. You have the just like we are creating a macro, we have the 50 line of steps, then 50 line of the code.
Mm-hmm.
And the 50 steps write in the algorithm and apply the code. And you can also write your code the next of your algorithm get the problem in your algorithm, apply the sum formula. This code is not know you. Then you resolve this line of the code. Okay, what is the code for the apply the formula? So you can also write the algorithm and write the front of the code in front of the algorithm. You can get the your exact know if you write this code, or if you have problem in the writing this code, if it's for some steps code you not know, so you can research and write the after write the code. Okay. So practice this today class on you, and next class will be conducted on the Monday, and we discuss about the code concept. That's it.
Okay, tomorrow is it possible? Because
sir, tomorrow is the Sunday. Saturday, Sunday we have off.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thanks.